We just had another Patch Tuesday. That's the day of the month where Microsoft and other tech companies usually release their security vulnerability patches and fixes for their software and operating systems. This month, Windows had 72 different exploits fixed, along with a bunch of other for their software. There were 69 different exploits from Apple patched, and Android has a bit of a different schedule, but this month there were about 31. So that would be 172 exploits, assuming I counted right, and that does include some actively exploited vulnerabilities. So you'll definitely want to check for updates. For example, in Windows, you can literally just go to the settings, hit check for updates. On iOS, you can check for updates there through the settings menu, same with Android. So what I'll do is go over some of the more significant ones, the higher severity ones from Windows mostly, and then also from Apple and Android. So first with Windows, of the different types of vulnerabilities, we had 17 that were elevation of privilege, 2 that were security feature bypass, 28 remote code execution, 15 information disclosure, 7 denial of service, and 2 spoofing vulnerabilities. Of these, there were 5 of them that are actively being exploited. They're 0 days, and all of them are high severity, and none of them need any kind of special privileges. That's in addition to all except the last one that I'll mention being low complexity, so attackers don't have to do all that much to exploit them. The first is a elevation of privilege vulnerability in the Microsoft Desktop Window Manager core library, and this is described as a use after free. So that might be something where a variable is used after it's already been disposed, as one of the memory ones that is an issue with memory safety. It does not require any kind of user interaction, and apparently it's vulnerable into different versions of Windows going back to Windows 10 1809. And on the report page, Microsoft says that this exploit allows the attacker to get system level privileges. So beyond administrators, like, you get the whole system. And actually, there's a few of these you'll see that allow that level. The next two exploits are pretty similar. They have the same title, both being elevation of privilege vulnerabilities for the Windows Common Log file system driver. However, the first one is a use after free, and this allows local elevation of privilege. And the second one is improper input validation. They both apparently require no user interaction, and both go back to Windows versions as early as Windows Server 2008, so it's an old bug. And just like the last one, these both allow system level privileges to the attacker if they can exploit it. The fourth one is also a elevation of privilege vulnerability for the Windows Ancillary Function Driver for WinSock. It's yet another use after free vulnerability, which, again, that's memory safety issue. So it's really no surprise that Microsoft is looking to rewrite some of their code in Rust, which is provably memory safe, but obviously most of Windows is not written in that. This one also requires no user interaction and is in Windows versions as early as Windows Server 2012. And for this one, it says that attackers would be able to gain administrator level privileges if they get it. And the fifth actively exploited 0 day is in the scripting engine. It's a memory corruption. This one is a type confusion vulnerability, and apparently this one would also allow attacking over the network, not just local. This one also goes way back, affecting versions as early as Windows Server 2008. However, this one does require user interaction, and also this one is high complexity. The descriptions say that it would require an attacker to first prepare the target device so that it uses Edge in Internet Explorer mode. So they might have to convince the user to do that first somehow, or maybe use another exploit to do that. And then it also says that the user would have to click on a specially crafted URL to be compromised by the attacker. Though I must say that just getting someone to click on something is not very high of a threshold. Probably the biggest challenge for them would be the Internet Explorer mode thing. Next up, we have Apple. They actually released updates on Monday, but close enough. Anyway, they released updates for basically all their operating systems, including features, but also security updates that they describe. So this includes iOS, iPadOS, macOS, tvOS, watchOS, even visionOS. And it looks like they disclosed 68 vulnerabilities yesterday and then updated one yesterday that was from earlier as well. And the categories of these exploits are anywhere from type confusion, improper access control, a bunch of memory exploits, and others. Let's just take a look at the three highest severity ones. They all, interestingly enough, had the same severity score of 8.8. That's pretty high. This first one looks like it was in basically all of their different operating systems. It had to do with WebKit, and the description says that processing maliciously crafted web content may lead to memory corruption. And this one does require user interaction though, but that may just be as simple as clicking a link. This next one looks to be just for macOS, and it's described as a file quarantine bypass, and it looks like they added additional checks to fix that. And apparently, the exploit allowed apps to break out of their normal sandbox. And this one does not require any user interaction. The third exploit also seems to be just for macOS, and the description says, connecting to a malicious AFP server may corrupt kernel memory, AFP being Apple Filing Protocol, so this is some kind of network exploit. And this one also requires no user interaction. There were also several other exploits that were of pretty high severity, around 8. Apparently, a few that even allowed apps to gain root privileges if exploited. So, yeah, kind of a big deal. And finally, moving on to Android, like I said, they're on a different schedule. It looks like they released patches on the first of the month as well as about a week ago. But still, in total, this month, it looks like they released around 30 CVEs that they patched. The highest severity were 7.8. There was actually 14 of them at that severity, most of them requiring no user interaction and all of them low complexity. There seemed to be a lot of privilege escalation, which makes sense. That's a classic one. And the types of the exploits include out-of-bound writes, missing authorization, improper input validation, and others. And it seemed like there weren't any of these that were particularly noteworthy besides just being general high severity, but nothing really groundbreaking. Still, of course, you'll want to update. I'm thinking about doing more of these Patch Tuesday updates, talking about the more severe critical vulnerabilities that have been patched every month. I wasn't able to get into as much detail as I would have liked in this one, mostly because I had to figure out how to aggregate all the info and download the XML describing all the descriptions, especially from companies like Apple, where they don't exactly publish the severity next to the ones they patched. So I had to like use the API from the NIST.gov to fetch all the info from the CVE names and then match them up. So it was a little bit more work than just me reading off the site. Anyway, I had to build all that out, which took time. But next time, I would be able to spend more time going into like actually analyzing the exploit. So let me know if you want me to do more of that going forward. So would love to hear what you think down in the comments. And of course, if you did enjoy the video, be sure to give it a big giant thumbs up. It helps out. And if you want to subscribe, I try to make videos about twice a week, so it should be worth it. If you want to keep watching, the next video you might be interested in is hearing about how Apple got absolutely wrecked recently by the courts and how it is probably going to save you a lot of money going forward. So I'll put that link right there you can click on. So thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.